Morning, my dear students. Welcome to our Swarthi online class. In the last class, we studied about, we completed the first chapter. And that class, we studied about different types of sexual reproduction. Okay, in the first class, we studied about different types of asexual reproduction. And the last class, we studied about different types of sexual reproduction. Okay, sexual reproduction meaning the fusion of both male and female gamete to form a zygote. And the zygote is developed into a new organism. This process is called sexual reproduction. Okay, and the conjugation and fertilization. For the conjugation and synergy, these two are the important types of sexual reproduction. Understand, my dear students? Okay, dear students, today we are going to start a new chapter. Our today's lesson is human reproduction. Okay, human reproduction is the second chapter for both biozoology and zoology students. So listen very carefully. So in this lesson, we are going to study about the structure and functions of the human reproductive system, both male and female reproductive system. Understand? See here, reproductive system is one of the very important system because this system only maintain the population, human population in the bird. Because the one and only major function is producing their young ones. Okay, so the human beings producing their young ones and maintaining their population in the world with the help of this system, reproductive system. Okay, so first we are going to study about the functions of our reproductive system. See, our reproductive system performing four important functions. The first function is producing the gamete. Male gamete is called sperm and the female gamete is called ovum or egg. The gamete means otherwise called, we can say, sexes. Okay, so the production of gamete is the first major functions of the reproductive system. Understand? And the second function is the transporting of this gamete from one place to another place. For example, the male gamete, the sperm is produced in the male reproductive system, but it should reach the female reproductive system for the fertilization process. Understand? So the male reproductive organs producing the male gamete. So that male gamete is transported through some places and finally it reaching the female reproductive system. So the transportation is the second major function of the reproductive system. Understand of you? And the third major function of the reproductive system is giving food to the developing embryo. See, In human beings, the embryo or the young baby is developing inside the uterus of the mother. Okay, maximum 9 months the baby is developing inside, or baby is inside the mother's uterus. Understand? So when the baby is developing inside the uterus of the mother, the baby getting the food and getting the gases through the female reproductive system. So the female reproductive system giving nutrients to the developing baby. So this is a third function. And the fourth function of the reproductive system is producing hormones, sex hormones. Okay, so testosterone and then progesterone, estrogen, like that, different types of hormones are secreted in the reproductive system. So these hormone secretion is the last function of the reproductive system. So I repeat once again all these four functions. First one is production of the gamete, second one is transportation of gamete, and the third one is nourishment to the developing embryo, and the last one is producing the sex hormone. These are the four functions of the reproductive system. Hope you are understood. Then next, so inside the reproductive system, some important events are taking place. Okay, some important events are taking place in both male and female reproductive system. So now we are going to study about all these events one by one. Listen very carefully. The first event is gametogenesis. The process of formation of both male and female gamete is called gametogenesis. Okay, male gamete, already I told you, male gamete is called sperm and the female gamete is called egg or ovum. So the process of production of these two, both male and female gamete in the male and female reproductive system is called gametogenesis. And the second one is insemination. The process of introducing, okay, or the process of transmitting the male sex cell into the female reproductive system is called insemination. The insertion of male gamete in the female reproductive system is called insemination. Then third one is fertilization. The process of fusion of both male and female gamete is called fertilization. Okay, the fusion or joining of sperm and ovum is called fertilization. And cleavage. See, at the end of this fertilization process, a new stage is formed. It is called zygote. It is called a zygote. Here, cleavage meaning this single cell zygote is divided into many cells, many multicellular blastocysts, but by mitotic cell division, this process is called cleavage. Cleavage meaning division. Single cellular zygote is divided into multicellular blastocysts. By mitotic cell division, this process is called cleavage. And the next one is implantation. The first place here, or the zygote is implanted or attached with the wall of the uterus of the female reproductive system, it is called implantation. It is called implantation. So the process of attachment of the blastocyst in the wall of the uterus of the female reproductive system is called implantation. The next one is gastrulation. The process of conversion of blastocyst into gastrula is called gastrulation. The process of conversion or transmission of blastocyst into gastrula is called gastrulation. So just imagine the gastrula. Inside this gastrula, three germ layers are formed. Three germ layers meaning ectoderm, endoderm, mesoderm. These are the germ layers. So when the cell, the zygote is transferred, the blastocyst is transported or converted into gastrula, immediately all the three germ layers also form inside the gastrula. So here gastrulation meaning the process of conversion of blastocyst into gastrula. Then organogenesis, the process of formation of different organs in the body of the fetus, is called organogenesis. Here fetus meaning that young ones which are developing inside the uterus of the mother is called fetus. Commonly we are saying baby. Okay. So young babies which are developing inside the uterus of the mother is called fetus. So all the organs are developed when the fetus is staying inside the uterus of the mother. So this process is called organogenesis. So organogenesis meaning the process of formation of different organs. Then next one is partition. Partition meaning the process of releasing or delivering the baby from the uterus of the mother to outside is called partition. Okay, the process of delivering the baby from the uterus to outside environment is called partition. So dear students, these are the important events take place in the reproductive system. One is the gametogenesis first event, second insemination, then fertilization, cleavage, implantation, gastrulation, organogenesis and partition. So these are the some of the important events take place in the body of the reproductive system, both male and female reproductive system. So dear friends, now we have completed two important topics. First, I explain about four important functions of the reproductive system. Now, I explain about the important events take place in the reproductive system. Understand? So, now we are going to study about the male reproductive system, structure and functions of male reproductive system. See, the male reproductive system, first we are going to study about the parts of male reproductive system. The male reproductive system is made up of many components or many parts. For example, a pair of testes, accessory duct, accessory gland, then external genital organ or external reproductive organ. So these are the some of the components or parts of our reproductive, male reproductive system. Understand? So now we are going to study about all these parts one by one. Listen very carefully. So the first part is testes. Testes is the primary male reproductive organ. Testes is the primary male reproductive organ. The major functions of the testes is production of the male sex cell or the production of the male gamete, the sperm. Sperm is the male gamete. So the major functions of the testes is production of healthy and effective sperm. Understand? The shape of the testes is oval shape. The shape of the testes is oval shape. So a pair of testes is present. Oval shape testes is present in the male reproductive system. Understand you? The next point. See, the testes is always hanging outside the abdominal cavity, and this testes is kept inside a sac or bag-like structure. Name of this bag-like structure is called scrotum. Okay, so outside the body or outside the abdominal cavity, a bag-like structure is there. It is called a scrotum. Inside the scrotum only, the testis is always kept. The reason is, the testis always need 2 to 3 degree lower temperature, 2 to 3 degree Celsius lower temperature than the normal body temperature. Then only the testis can produce effective sperm. So to produce effective sperm, the testis need 2 to 3 degree Celsius lower temperature than the normal body temperature. So that only the testis is always hanging inside the scrotum and the scrotum is always present outside the body of the abdominal cavity. So the scrotum is act as a thermoregulator, regulating the temperature. Most of you understand? Then, next point. See, the outer surface of the testis is covered by a small membrane. Okay, covered by a membrane. Name of this membrane is called tunica albuginea. Tunica albuginea. Understand? Then, inside the testis is divided into 200 to 250 small lobules. Okay. So the testis is the inner side, the testis is divided into 250 small lobules. Okay, then next part, each lobule, so today 200 to 250 lobules are there. So each lobule is consist of, each lobule is consist of 2 to 4 highly coiled tube like structure. These tube-like structures are called seminiferous tubule. Okay, so inside each and every lobules of the testis, 2 to 4 highly coiled tube-like structure is there. This is called seminiferous tubule. This seminiferous tubule only is the site for the production of sperm. So the sperm is produced inside the seminiferous tubule of the testis. Understand? So inside each and every lobules, 2 to 4 seminiferous tubules are present. Hope you understood this one. Then, our testis, the seminiferous tubule. So inside the testis, 2 important types of cells are present. Okay, 2 important cells are present. One cell name is called Sertoli cells and the second cell's name is called Leydig cells. Here the Sertoli cells is elongated cells. Okay, long cells and pyramid shaped cells, and the main functions of this Sertoli cell is giving nourishment. Okay, so the sperm is producing inside the seminiferous tubule, and till the sperm getting maturation, these Sertoli cells only giving food or nutrients to the sperm. Okay, so still reaching the maturation, the sperm receiving their nutrients from this Sertoli cell. So this is the first function of the Sertoli cells. And the Sertoli cells producing one more hormone. One hormone, name of this hormone is called incubin. So the incubin is the hormone secreted by the Sertoli cells. This incubin hormone playing a very important role in the production of sperm. Okay, so the production of sperm is also controlled by this incubin hormone. So dear students, I repeat this point one more time. See, our testis has 2 important seminiferous tubule consist of 2 important cells. One is Sertoli cell and second is Leydig cells. Here this Leydig cells performing 2 important functions. One is the nourishment. Till the sperm getting maturation, the sperm receiving the nutrients from the Sertoli cells. And the second one, the Sertoli cells producing a hormone, name of this hormone is called incubin. This incubin hormone controls the production of sperm. Hope you are understood this one. The second cell is the Leydig cells. These Leydig cells play a very important role in the production of male sex hormone testosterone. Testosterone is the male sex hormone. It is produced inside the testis, and this hormone is produced by the Leydig cells of the testis. And this hormone also controls the spermatogenesis process. Spermatogenesis, already I told you, the process of production of sperm. The process of production of the male gamete is called spermatogenesis. So this spermatogenesis also controlled by this Leydig cell. So Sertoli cells, Leydig cells, these two are the cells present in the testis. Hope you all understood all these points. So that's all about the testis. Then, second, accessory duct, tube. The male reproductive system consists of many ducts. Through this duct only, the sperm is moving from the testis to outside. Okay, listen very carefully. See where the testis, vas efferentia, vasa efferentia, epididymis, then vas deferens, seminal vesicles. So these are the important duct. Duct means tube. So through these tubes only, the sperm is producing or moving from the testis. Okay, so inside the seminiferous tubule of the testis, the sperm is produced, as I told you. Okay, so the seminiferous tubule is connected with another one duct. Name of this duct is called right testis. Okay, so from the seminiferous tubule, the sperm is moving to the right testis. From the right testis, the sperm is moving to the or entering in the vasa efferentia. Then from the vasa efferentia, the sperm is moving to the epididymis. Here epididymis is a highly coiled tube-like structure, and this epididymis is act as a temporary reservoir or temporary storage place of the sperm. Okay, still the sperm is getting maturation, the sperm is stored or staying inside this epididymis. Okay, so it's a temporary storage place of the reproductive system. Okay, male reproductive system is epididymis. Okay, so now the sperm is entering inside or staying inside the epididymis. Then from the epididymis, the sperm is moving to the next duct or next tube. It is called a vas deferens. This vas deferens is connected with another one tube. It is called seminal vesicles. So this vas deferens and the seminal vesicle both are togetherly forming a common ejaculatory duct. Okay, so this common ejaculatory duct moving through the urethra and coming outside. Okay, so the sperm is first entering inside the right testis from the seminiferous tubule. Then from the right testis, it is moving to the vasa efferentia. From the vasa efferentia, the sperm is moving inside the epididymis. Then inside the epididymis, they are staying for a short period. Okay. Then from the epididymis, the sperm is moving to the ejaculatory duct through this vas deferens and seminal vesicle. Okay. Then from the ejaculatory duct, the sperm is moving to the urethra. From the urethra, the sperm is coming outside. Here, urethra is the last part of the excretory system. You all know the structure of the excretory system. Kidney, ureter, then the urinary bladder, the end of this urinary bladder is called urethra. Okay, so through this urethra only, both the urine and the sperm, okay, both are coming outside in different times, both not joined together like that. Okay, so the urine is coming in one time and the semen is coming or the sperm is coming out another time. Okay, so through this urethra only, both sperm and urine are coming in different time. Understand of you? Understand? So this is the structure of the what? Accessory duct. Understand? So now we completed the accessory duct. Then next one is the accessory gland. See, inside the male reproductive system, many glands are there. These glands are secreting different types of fluids. Okay, different types of fluids. So these fluids only finally forming a common fluid is called semen. It is called a semen. So now we are going to study about some important glands present in the male reproductive system. Listen very carefully. See, the first gland is seminal vesicle. This seminal vesicle gland secreting a fluid. Name of the fluid is called seminal plasma. This seminal plasma is alkaline in nature. It is alkaline in nature. And it consists of a sugar. Name of the sugar is called fructose. Name of the sugar is called a fructose. It consists of one acid. Name of the acid is called ascorbic acid. And it consists of one enzyme. Name of that enzyme is called vesiculase. So, seminal vesicle is the gland present in the male reproductive system. This gland secreting a fluid is called seminal plasma. This seminal plasma is alkaline in nature. It consists of fructose, ascorbic acid, and an enzyme called vesiculase. Hope you understood. Then, next gland is called bulbourethral gland. Next gland is called the bulbourethral gland. This bulbourethral gland also secreting a fluid. This fluid is helps for the lubrication of the penis at the time of ejaculation. okay, at the time of reproductive activities. So during the sexual activities, for the lubrication of the penis, one fluid is needed. That fluid is secreted by the bulbourethral gland of the male reproductive system. The next gland is the prostate gland. So this prostate gland secreting a fluid, this fluid is in acidic nature. Then this fluid consists of citrate and many enzymes. Are present in the fluid secreted by the prostate gland. Then next one is 7. So the glands, all these glands are secreting some fluid, as I told you. Okay. So all these fluids are togetherly forming the 7. So here 7 is a milky white color fluid. It consists of more amount of sperm. Understand? Then this 7 is act as a transport medium. That means the sperm is moving through this 7. Okay, the sperm is, there are millions of sperms are produced per day. All these sperms are moving through this 7 only. So the 7 is acting as a transport medium. Then it also supplying the nutrients to the sperm. When the sperm is staying inside the 7, the sperm is getting their nutrients from the 7. And it consists of more amount of chemicals. These chemicals are very, very important for the protection of the sperm, and these chemicals are very, very important for the movement of the sperm. So more amount of chemicals are present in the semen. The functions of these chemicals, protection and the movement of sperm, helps in the protection and helps in the movement of sperm. Understand? Hope you understood this point. So now we completed the accessory gland, and now we are going to finish the last part of the male reproductive system, penis. Penis is the external genital organ or external reproductive organ. It is made up of special types of tissue. And these tissues are getting erection during the sexual activities. Okay. So these tissues are erected during the sexual activities. Understand of you? Then at the end of the penis, a small swelling is there. That means the enlarged portion of the penis is called gallant penis. Understand? And this enlargement, the end of the penis is covered by a folded skin. Name of this folded skin is called foreskin or called perpus. Okay? So at the end of this penis, enlargement is there, it's called gallant penis, and it is covered by a folded skin. This is called foreskin, otherwise called perpus. Understand, my dear students? Yes, students, now we have completed the structure and functions of the male reproductive system. Okay, already I told you our male reproductive system consists of a pair of testes, many accessory ducts, many accessory glands, and external reproductive organs. Okay, so now we completed the structure and functions of the male reproductive system. Hope you are understood today's class. So if you have a book, you take one study by using the book. Otherwise, take short notes and study. Understand? So don't waste your time. We will meet in the next class. Thank you.